The Supreme Court is postponing their review of a case that could have implications for abortion access in this country. The High Court had been slated to hear a petition on Friday. A new review date has not yet been set. The case looks at a blocked Mississippi law that bans abortions after 15 weeks into pregnancy. CBS News reporter Kate Smith has been covering this story, and she joins us now from New York City. Kate, tell us more about the Mississippi case. Why did the Fifth District Court decide to block the state's ban on abortions after 15 weeks of pregnancy?
Well, Lana, so far judges have been very blunt about how they feel about this law. On an appellate level, they said that this is simply a violation of Roe v. Wade. Now, Roe v. Wade guarantees women in this country the availability of abortion until fetal viability. That tends to happen about 24 weeks into a person's pregnancy. Now, the problem with that is anything, any sort of ban, gestational ban before 24 weeks, is in violation of Roe v. Wade. That can be a 15-week ban or a 6-week ban or an all-out ban. All of those are in violation of Roe. So what you've seen judges, how they've responded to this, is that this is simply against Roe. And so we have to abide by the Constitution. And right now, the way the Supreme Court interprets the Constitution is that any sort of pre-viability abortion ban is therefore against Roe. And in fact, the district court that originally blocked this law, he was very blunt in his words and a very biting opinion. He accused the state actually of abusing the judicial system to try to push their legislative agenda of overturning Roe. And you know, Lana, what you're seeing here is just one of the very many state initiatives to try to overturn Roe.
Well, the state's only abortion provider asked the Supreme Court to decline hearing the case. What was their argument?
So their argument is simple, and it's one that the judges have said. They say that this is simply against Roe v. Wade. There is settled law precedent that protects a person's access to abortion before fetal viability. Now, what the state says is that it's a little bit more complicated. Earlier this year, the Supreme Court ruled in June Medical Service versus Rousseau. Now, that decision ultimately struck down a Louisiana abortion regulation, but it wasn't quite that simple. What happened was the liberal bloc had its own opinion, striking down the law. And Roberts, though he joined the liberal bloc, he wrote a concurrence. And in that concurrence, he raised other issues. And now what you're seeing at lower court levels is that they're not exactly sure whether to take Roberts' opinion or the liberal bloc's opinion, and which one of those is actually the holding opinion in that case. And so what Mississippi argues is that this 15-week abortion ban would be a good opportunity for the court to, you know, provide some guidance on that, which of these opinions should they find holding, so the confusion ends at the appellate level. However, that state's only abortion clinic says, wait a minute, that was just a law about abortion regulations. What we're talking about is a wholesale ban on abortion, which is not related to regulation. In fact, that's a ban that's covered by Roe v. Wade, and what they say, there's simply no confusion over it.
Well, this is the fourth time that the court has rescheduled reviewing the petition for this case. How common is it for a case to continue to be pushed back like this?
It's not terribly common, and when I've been speaking to some of my sources, they provided a few different, opinions of why this might happen. And I should also note that we'll never know exactly why this was rescheduled. But there's a few different reasons, and one might be that they're planning to decline the case, and there's a dissent being written, and that takes some time. You would probably see Justices Thomas and Alito, perhaps writing a dissent, and again, that takes time. It would require them to, you know, write the dissent, and it wouldn't be as simple as just hearing the case, deciding, and moving on. Another theory that I've been hearing in kind of legal circles is that they would like Judge Barrett to participate in this. And, you know, as we know, today was Justice Barrett's fourth day on the job. It would be very difficult for her to be fully briefed and read in on this case. As we've seen, she's recused herself from some cases because she hasn't been able to get up to speed yet. Of course, this is just her first week on the job. So one theory I've also heard is that they are waiting for that justice to fully brief herself on the case and be able to participate in the vote. Now, Lana, what's really important here is that you only need four justices to agree to hear a case. So her vote could become very critical down the line when we're thinking about whether or not the court's going to take this case.
Yeah, I know a lot of people are very interested in seeing how the new justice is going to weigh in, particularly on cases regarding abortion rights. All right, Kate Smith, thank you.